Zero, can you hear me? I'm not hearing you. Sasha, please check your mic. I can hear you. I can hear you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I'm not hearing Sister Sharon. God bless you. Okay.
I'll just go quickly get notebook to my own.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Sasha, can you lead us in prayer, please? 5 minutes. God bless you.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Increase the volume, please. Okay, let's have a word of prayer. Praise the Lord. It seems that Sister Sharon's mic is not coming up. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this evening. We want to open our voices right now and worship the name of our God. Let's bless the name of God. Let's worship him for another time in his presence. For how he has been with us throughout the week. For how he has guided us when we went to school, came back, has helped us in the family. Let's open our hearts and our mouths to worship the name of our God. Father, we bless you. We worship you. We thank you, Lord in heaven, for your goodness, for your kindness upon us, your children. Thank you, Father. Lord, we are grateful unto you. Be thou exalted, O God. Be magnified in the name of Jesus. Father, thank you, Father, for your faithfulness. Thank you, Lord, for your mercy upon us. Thank you, Lord, for your love towards every one of your children. Be thou exalted, O God. In Jesus' mighty name, we have given thanks.
Amen.
Amen. We want to plead for God's mercy. At this moment, we want to ask for God's mercy in any way we have sinned against him, in any way we have disobeyed his word, in any way we have come short of his glory. Let's plead for God's mercy, that God will have mercy upon us as children, so that this night again the Lord is going to speak to us. Nothing will stand between us and God, in Jesus' name. My Father, my God, we come before you now. We are praying for your mercy. And is there anything, Lord, in heaven, you have asked us not to do, and we have gone ahead to do it? Anything you have asked us to do, and we didn't obey? Father, we are pleading, oh God, that you have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon all your children this evening. We want to hear from you now, Lord. Anything that would have made the devil to make us not to be able to receive your blessing. Father, Lord, we ask, oh God, that you have mercy upon us. Forgive us, cleanse us from every unrighteousness. With your blood, with the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray that for mercy.
Amen.
Amen. We want to pray for this evening's program. We want to ask the Holy Spirit to come and teach us. We want to ask that the Spirit of the Living God will teach us this night what God himself wants us to hear. We have come here to learn from our God. We have come here to have the word of life. That God will open our hearts. He will teach us. We will obey his word. We will hear his word. We will understand this night. And we will not live here the same way we came, in Jesus' name. Holy Spirit of living God, we have come, O Lord, hear from our Father. I pray that you open our ears, to hear from you, open our eyes to see what you want us to see in your word. We don't want to come here and go back the same. We are asking that your Holy Spirit, the Holy Spirit of the Most High God, will come and teach us this night the word you want us to hear in the name of Jesus Christ. And give us the grace, Father, Lord, in heaven, to be obedient to your word. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
We want to pray for our teacher this evening, that the Lord will speak to our teacher, that our teacher will not speak of herself, but she will hear from God, and she will speak through the word of God, through the power of God, that the Lord will anoint our teacher this night to be able to teach us what God himself wants us to know in Jesus' name. Let's pray for our teachers. Father, Lord, we lift up our teacher before you. We are asking and praying, Lord, your power, you are closer, your spirit will closer, that you're able to speak your word, and your children will hear this night. God, teach us through her in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you because we will do more than we can ask you. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Amen. Father, we thank you. We bless you. We magnify your name for this evening. We have come again into your presence, O God Almighty. We ask and pray that your presence, the mighty presence of the Most High God, will enclose every one of us, every one of your children this night in Jesus' mighty name. Father, we are ready to hear from you. I pray that, Lord, nothing will distract us from hearing from you. You teach us what you want us to know this night in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father, for your answers to our prayers. We commit our teacher into your hands, O God. You speak through her to us, O God, in Jesus' name. We bless you, Father, for your answers to our prayers. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Where is that? Okay, good. Please, can we unmute? I'm going to unmute everybody. And can we also bring put our video so that we can know those that are around? Because everybody have to participate this night as well. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. God bless you. Now it's time for us to go into worship. I'm looking at our Allen brethren. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We want to go into worship. I want to sing our song, Obedience. So we want Island Brethren to help us to sing the song, and every other children who are going to join in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen.
Obedience is the best thing we show that you believe. Doing those things that the Lord commands, do them faithfully.
Everybody join in now. Amen.
Obedience is the very best way to
You are welcome to our children this evening in Jesus' mighty name. So can we see our baby Glory that is joining us today, please? We want to know how old she is so that we can involve her in our activity, please. Sister Rita? Can you hear me? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Children, we all welcome back to our children program this evening in Jesus' mighty name. Now we are going to go back, flashback to our last week's what we did last week. So I'm going to be calling some people to tell us what we did last week. I'm going to start with Sister Isoke. Bless you.
No.
Yeah? Sister Isoke?
Yeah.
No.
Increase the volume. Can't hear you very well.
He knows a verse. I learned the NIV version. It says, my son.
Can you increase your volume a little bit, please? We are not hearing you. We want to hear you very well.
Okay.
Thank you. God bless you.
My son. We did Proverbs.
No, not the memory verse yet. We want to remember what we learned last week.
Last week, we were talking about not going, that we shouldn't go to the people that do evil.
Okay.
And that we shouldn't flow in their footsteps, what they're doing is evil, and that if people think that they're doing the will of God, even though they're not, we shouldn't follow we shouldn't follow the footsteps of evil.
Okay. God bless you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Okay, I want somebody from Ireland to tell us what we studied last week. I can see some hands up. God bless you, Sister Isoke. Okay, go ahead. We are listening to you.
David and the Lion. Thanks. David and the Lion.
Go ahead, hurry up. Good boy, thank you very much. God bless you. Hurry up.
We learned about David in the lion's den. We learned about David in the lion's den. In the lion's den.
Okay, Daniel in the lion's den. God bless you.
How he trusted God. So he told us that we should trust in God so that anytime any enemy come near us, they try to kill us, just trust in him like Daniel.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Daniel trusted in God, and God came to his rescue and delivered him from the mouth of lion. So today, if we trust in the Lord, every enemy that wants to come and harm us, the Lord himself will deal with them, and we will not be harmed as Daniel was not harmed in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Sister Sharon, okay, Sister Sharon wasn't here last week. Sister Fortune?
Yeah?
Can you remember what happened to the people that wanted to throw, that made the king to throw Daniel into the lion's den? Can you remember
what happened to them? I totally remember.
You can't remember? Who can remember?
I can.
Yeah. Huh? Give me a candy.
Joshua, can you remember?
No. Yeah.
Okay, who's going to help out? I can see hand in Ireland as well. Yes, my brother on the right here. Yeah. God bless you. Mary. Go ahead.
I got mama.
Sister, edit mute and mic, please.
They guard minds and wives and children
Can you help us with the volume?
Okay, Dodo, can you increase the volume? Sorry, but it's just because there's too many noise in the background.
Okay.
Move forward.
They got thrown into the lion's den, and the wives and children got thrown into the lion's den as well, and then they got injured by the lions.
Okay, praise the Lord. We can see last week that those that planned evil against Daniel, by the time God delivered Daniel, they were asked, they were called in for themselves, their wives, their children. They were all thrown into the lion's den, and they were the one that were eaten by the lions. So that is to tell us today that those evil men that are planning evil against us, by the time we trust in our God as Daniel did, God will fight for us, and what they plan, the evil they plan against us, it will be turned against them in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Praise the Lord. So those that were not here last week, at least you can know now what we studied last week, and know that it is good to always put our trust in the Lord. Amen. So before we go into today's activity, time is already going now. I want to call on a few people to tell us about our memory verse last week. I'm going to start with Divine. And who was here last week? Ivan is going to tell us for the younger ones, and Fortune, be prepared to tell us the one the older kids are meant to.
I wasn't here because my internet turned me off when you told us.
Okay. Who was here last week? Sharon wasn't here last week. Sapis wasn't here last week. Oh, okay, Soken. Okay. So let me start with Divine. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
God bless you. You are listening.
Right.
Divine.
Okay, I remember.
Okay, I'll come back to you. It's okay. Can you go ahead now with yours, please? God bless you.
Okay. Proverbs 1:8. Proverbs 1:10-11.
Yes.
My son, if sinners entice you, do not come to them. If they say, come with us, let us lie in wait for blood. Let us ambush the innocent without reason.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You hear that? Let's give Jesus a clap of praise. My son, if sinner entice you, consent thou not. When sinners, people that don't know God, cause you, say, let's go and do something evil, do not follow them to do what is wrong, because you are a child of the Most High God. Do we hear that?
Yes, ma.
Children, do we hear that?
Yes.
Okay. Next time, maybe in your school, someone that wants to go and do something that is wrong, cause and say, let's go and do this thing together. You know already that thing is wrong. What are you going to say?
No.
The Lord will give us the grace to say no to the devil in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Divine, are you ready for us now? God bless you again. Divine. Praise the Lord. Divine is not ready for us this today. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
We are going to go into today's study. And by the grace of God, our sister Samaria will be teaching us. I want us to be attentive, listen to the word of God, listen to what God is going to teach us this night. And I know we all be blessed in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Samaria. God bless you. Samaria. Praise the Lord. Where has she gone to? Okay, before Samaria come back to us. Maybe she has having a problem with her internet. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Okay, before our sister come back to us, I want to tell us throughout the week, from Monday by the grace of God or Tuesday, I want our mommies to please check our inbox, because by next week, God helping us, if Christ tarry, we are going to have start our activity. We are going to have our activity for next week. So I'm going to be sending to us what the younger kids are going to be doing and what the older kids are going to be doing. So please make sure your mommy checks their inbox, print out whatsoever needed to be printed out, and whatsoever assignment we meant to go over it, revise it. And by the grace of God, next week we are going to do some activities. Is that clear?
Yes.
God bless you. So, Sister Dupe. Okay, I'm going to be sending what we're going to be doing next week. I'm going to send it to you. I'm going to send one to Joseph so that you can print more for the children. And then those that I know their email, I'm going to send it to them as well.
Okay.
God bless you. So our sister is back. God bless you, Sister Maria. Over to you, ma.
What they call it, technology here. The light is shutting off and on, and my computer is not constant.
We can hear you.
Just give me 5 minutes, please.
Okay, praise the Lord.
Hello.
Now we have.
Yeah.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Almost everything I have is just. They're just. I don't know what's happening.
It is worse, sir. We just give few minutes and go over our memory verse. If she's able to come back, fine. If not, we continue. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Paul and Akaila.
My son.
Kyla.
Yeah.
God bless you. Can you tell us our memory verse for last week that we asked us to, a Bible passage we asked us to memorize last week?
Yes, stand up. They're talking to you, Kyla. Don't be shy. Stand up.
Kyla. Don't be shy. We are waiting for you.
Sing it. Stand up and sing it now. Kyla.
Sorry.
No one is hearing you. Say, my son, stand up. And say,
my son.
They're waiting for you.
I don't know what to say.
You know.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Okay. Our brethren from Saudi Arabia, we want to see us, please. What's going on? We know we were not here last week. Okay. Now, today, before we will send the activity for next week, I still want us, because many people were not here last week, I want us to write down our memory verse for next week. Our memory verse for next week, please.
I'm working on fix that.
Are we ready?
Yes, I'm good.
God bless you. Proverbs chapter 2, verse 1 for the younger kids. Proverbs chapter 2, verse 1. Have we written that for our younger kids? Sister Mobolaji. Sister Mobolaji. God bless you, ma.
God bless you, ma.
Yes, ma. Do we have a child there, please, ma?
I have.
How old is he or she?
He's 13. Dangerous for him.
Okay, 13. God bless. God bless you. What's her name? Ma? I'm not hearing, ma.
Faith, Adebanke, Faith.
Okay, Faith. Okay, Faith. I'm going to give her, going to give the older kids their memory verse now. And I want to write it down, please.
Okay,
we are going to Psalm 119. Psalm 119, verse 11. Have we written that down? Every one of us, please. The older kids, Psalm 119, verse 11.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, and the second one, the same Psalm 119.
Okay.
Verse 130. Psalm 119. Verse 130. Did we get that?
Yep.
I got it.
Okay. The younger kid is Proverbs chapter 2, verse 1. The older kid, Psalm 119, verse 11. And Psalm 119, verse 130. Please, I want every one of us to read this, memorize it. If you don't understand, ask mommy to please help explain to you so you understand it. And by the grace of God, on next week, Saturday, almost every one of us, we should be ready to recite our memory. God bless you. Sister Isaac, can you raise up your hand?
I didn't really get the one for the older kids.
The older kid is Psalm 119. Verse 11. And the second one, Psalm 119, verse 130. God bless you. Baby Glory, did you write that down? Yes. Mm-hmm. Island brother, did you get everything?
Yes.
God bless you.
Yes, ma.
God bless you all. Samaria, are we ready now?
Yes, ma. So
God
sorry.
Bless you.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
They have a word of prayer. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ,
I want to go.
Thank you, Lord Jesus, for your protection. We thank you for making it possible with your God and your presence. Oh Lord Jesus, as we want to study your word, for your words in the book of John, 1 John 1:1, in the beginning was the word was with God, the word was God. Father, as we are about to study your word, Father, we need your understanding, we need your wisdom, knowledge in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Help us, oh God, as the children hear the word that they are going to hear our in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Father, Lord God, the heaven and to our God, use me, oh God, to the glory of your name, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My Father, my God, I have no words of my own, I have no power of my own, I have no wisdom of my own. I pray, oh God, you manifest yourself in me, and let your name be glorified in Jesus' mighty name, I pray.
Amen. Volume, God bless you.
Thank you, Lord. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Our topic today, we are going to talk about forgiveness. Forgiveness is a topic that is very important for us. Before we go further, let me just explain the meaning of forgiveness. Listen very carefully. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Are we hearing?
Yes.
Sister, can everyone mute their mic? Can everybody mute their mic?
Okay.
Please.
Samaria, please hold on. Let's please, can we mute our mic so that we can hear, please? God bless you.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
As I was saying, I said today we are going to look at the topic called forgiveness. What is forgiveness? The word forgiveness me to wipe the stain and clean. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
What forgiveness means to wipe the stain clean, to pardon, to cancel a debt. When we wrong someone, we seek their forgiveness in order for the relationship to be restored. Forgiveness is a thing that everyone we have that will make you to be closer to God. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Forgiveness is granted because a person desires to be forgiven. No one desires to be forgiven. Forgiveness is an act of love, mercy, grace. Forgiveness is a decision not to hold on to something against somebody else, despite what they have done to you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Forgiveness is a thing that when somebody wrong you, you have to go and meet the person and say, oh, you wronged me. The person, you ask forgiveness through the person, and the person, when he know what he did was very wrong, because of the fear of God in him, he will forgive you. The Bible said, because of the love God has for us, because in this world, we are all sinners, as the Bible said. In the book of Ecclesiastes 7, verse 20. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I just explained it. It said, the Bible tells us that we are all in need of forgiveness from God. We have committed sin. There is no a righteous man on earth who does what is right and never sin. If we claim to be without sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. All sin is ultimate as act of rebellion against God. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
That is why forgiveness is very important. Because of the love that God has for us, he came to die for us, for we to obtain that forgiveness. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Forgiveness is a thing. As children of God, we need to forgive one another. As it said in the book of Ephesians 4:32. He said, be ye kind to one another, tender heart, forgive one another, even as God, for Christ's sake, had forgiven us. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
As a child of God, you don't need to keep malice in your heart. If you want to make heaven, you don't keep grudges with anybody. You must make sure your heart is free, because if you have malice in your heart or you have grudge with somebody, it makes your heart to be heavy. You are not free. It's like you have a bondage in your life. That is why it's always good to forgive one another. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
He said, and when we stand praying, forgiveness. Praise the Lord. And when we stand and when we start praying, forgive if ye ought against any, praise the Lord. Sorry for that. If we confess our sin, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and cancel all our sins. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Why forgiveness is very important? Because if you don't forgive, you cannot make heaven. As a children of God, when you are in school, and somebody offend you, don't keep it in your heart. Because when you keep it in your heart, if trumpet and sand, because of that thing in your heart, you cannot be able to make it to heaven. By the grace of God, I believe we all want to make it to heaven. That is why when you have grudges in your heart, as maybe in the class, somebody stole your barrel, and you find out that it's somebody that stole your barrel, don't be angry. Just let the person know that what you did was not good. Next time, don't do it again. Just because you are a child of God, you forgive him or you forgive her. Praise the Lord. Because God loves us, he forgives us. Because God forgives us, we still have to forgive one another. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
In the book of Matthew 6:14-15 says, if we forgive men their praise the Lord. If we forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you read all the children admitted, I think I probably asked one or two people to read.
No, anyone you ask to read, she or he will meet himself.
Okay. Sister Fortune, can you please read Matthew 6:14-15 for us?
Matthew 6:14-16, right?
Yes. Okay, I read it. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Matthew 6, 40 to 15 says, if ye forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if ye forgive not men their trespasses, neither will your heavenly Father forgive you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
This is telling us that when somebody offends us, we need to forgive them so that our heavenly Father will also forgive us. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
If we read one story in the book of Luke 15, this boy is maybe most of all know the story before, the prodigal son. The prodigal son offended his father. When he realized that if he ends his life like that, he might die and go to hell, he went to reconcile back with his father. And because the father know the word of God, that forgiveness is the key to make it, the father forgive his son and take his battle himself. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
As you read in the book, I read the book of Luke 15, I start from 11. And he said, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And said, a certain man had two sons. And the younger of them said to his father, give me the portion of good that falleth to me, and divided unto me his living. Praise the Lord. 13. Mm-hmm. And not many days after the young son gathered all together, he took his journey into a far country. There wasted his substance. Righteously life. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And when he had spent all that arose, he arose and meet. Praise the Lord. I read again, verse 14. And when he had spend all, there arose a mighty famine in that land. He began to be in want. 15. And he went and joined himself to a citizen of that country, and he sent him into a farm of to feed swine. 16. And he would faint have fallen his belly with the hawks that the swine did eat. And no man give unto him. 17. And when he came to himself, he said, how many hired servants my fathers have bread enough to spend, and I perish with hunger. I arose and go to my father. Where I want you to really get is 18. When the boy realized that he now is very hungry because of the life he live, now realized the mistake. So he said, "I arose and go to my father. And we say unto him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before thee, and am no worthy to be called your son. Make me as of their hired servants. And he arose and came to his father. But when he was yet a great way off, his father saw him and had compassion and ran and fell on his neck and kissed him. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You see, even when the child scandalized the father's words, because of the love the father had for him, he still forgive him. That is why we must forgive one another. No matter how somebody offend you, no matter how the offense may be, we have to forgive one another because Jesus Christ also forgive us. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
As in the book of 1 Corinthians 10:13 says, there have no temptation come, praise the Lord. Sorry for that. The book of Luke 6:37 says, judge not and ye not be judged. Condemn not and ye should not be condemned. Forgive and ye shall be forgiven. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
What this scripture is saying is that when you see that as you a child of God, somebody offend you, don't say because this one is a sinner, don't judge the person, I will not forgive him. No, because you're a child of God, you have to forgive the person so that you, through your forgiveness, you can even win the person to the kingdom of God. That is why forgiveness is very important, to forgive. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
The Bible also said, the Bible tells us about to forgive one another. The only just penalty for our sin is death. The first half of Romans 6:23 said, for the wages of sin is dead, but the gift of God is eternal life. So if you don't forgive somebody, you are holding sin in your life. When you forgive, it will lessen your, you will not have what bothers you in your heart. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
As we go, the reason why forgiveness is important, number one, unforgiveness stands between you and God. Why? Because we all sin, and through grace, God has forgiven us and see us as righteous. If God can forgive us all our sin, we have to do the same thing likewise, to forgive one another. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
For if we forgive other people when we sin against them, your heavenly Father will also forgive you, just as I read before in the book of Matthew 6:14-15. So forgiveness is good for you and I. If we harbor unforgiveness, you will be holding on to bitterness and thinking. If you harbor something in your heart, there will be bitterness. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
He said, sinning and opening a door to the enemy to get into your life. I read number two again, the point number two. Forgiveness is good for you and I. If we harbor unforgiveness, you will be holding onto bitterness and thinking bitterly of other. Sinning and open a door to the enemy to get into your life because of the havoc which is in your heart. Because you keep somebody in your heart, whenever you see the person, your mind for the person will not be good because you have unforgiveness inside. But when you forgive the person, when you see the person, there will be joy in your heart. There will be love in your heart. There will be peace in your life. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Point number three. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I will do to them as they have done to me. I will pay them back with what they have done to me. As a child of God, if somebody do you something that is not good, do not pay them back with evil. As a child of God, don't pay evil with evil. We pay good with evil. Praise the Lord. That is why we are children of God. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Forgiveness is mainly for your benefit. not for the benefit of the person you are forgiving, as long as you are falling a victim, you are carrying a heavy burden. Forgiveness allows you to put the burden down and simply walk away free with a free heart. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
When you forgive somebody, why forgiveness is very important. When you forgive somebody, you have a clear conscience, you have a pure heart, you are happy, and you are glad. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah. Forgiveness helps us to grow. Once you have forgiven someone in your life, you feel happy. Your life have a meaning. You suddenly find you have more time to think something that is good. When you forgive someone, instead of you to be thinking what somebody did to you, you think positive things, because you don't have grudges in your heart, you don't have malice in your heart, you don't have what you are thinking that is not good. Because of that, it's good to forgive. Forgiveness is very, very, very important, because Jesus Christ forgive us, we ought to forgive others. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
If you read in the book of Proverbs 24, verse 29, Proverbs 24, verse 29. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I read Proverbs 24:29, then two other scriptures, and then I hand over to Caroline. Praise the Lord.
And because of time, please, that last verse, so that they can have time to.
Okay.
God bless you.
Proverbs 24:29. Say not, I will do to them that are done to me. I will return the man according to his work. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
As I explained before, that is the scripture that I just quoted now. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
God bless you, Sister Caroline.
God bless you. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Can we unmute our minds, please? Unmute your mind, please, everyone. God bless you. Praise the Lord. Do we understand what we are taught this evening?
Yes.
Okay, who can just summarize quickly what he or she gained from the teaching of our sister this evening? God bless you. Yes? Okay, Sister Isoken. I want a hand from Ireland, please. Then Sister Sharon.
Which one's a hand from there?
Sorry, I'm not hearing you, please.
What did you say?
I hear for me.
That's okay, I'm listening. Okay, Sister Dupa, a hand from Ireland.
Yes.
Okay, and then Daniel, go ahead. I want to be sure we understand what we are taught this evening.
When you forgive others, God will forgive you.
Amen. When you forgive others, God will forgive you. Okay, go ahead. Is that Benjamin?
Yes, ma'am.
God bless you.
Today, a lot of forgiveness. If someone does evil to you, you don't pay them the evil. You tell them to stop it, and if they don't stop, just put in your mind, forgive them and forgive or forget.
Amen. Praise the Lord. That is the word. Forgive and forget. Why? Because Jesus Christ forgave us. We are sinners. If Jesus didn't forgive us today, we wouldn't be a friend of Jesus. We wouldn't have heaven to go. Don't say, because this person has done wrong to me, I'm going to also pay the person back. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Learn to forgive one another. even in the house with your younger ones, with your elder ones, once someone offend you, what do we need to do? Call the person, I didn't like what you did, talk it over, forgive and
forget.
Amen. God will give us the grace to forgive and to forget in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Okay, I am Sister Sharon.
Yes, ma'am.
What did you learn today? God bless you.
I learned that if example that you're in a fight with someone, that you should not have grudges in your heart, that you should always try to forgive the person and tell the person what you've done wrong.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We must not have unforgiveness in our heart, because unforgiveness will make us to not be friend of Jesus. If we don't forgive, we cannot go to heaven. And we want to go to heaven, we want to see our Jesus. We will never be among those that will be having somebody in our mind in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Yes, sister, it's okay. You are ready for us now. God bless you.
We were talking about forgiveness. Then we're reading Luke. Then it said, it didn't exactly say there, but if God can forgive us, we can forgive other people.
Amen.
And when you forgive somebody, that has meaning and you will be together.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. God forgave us, so we must forgive others in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Yes, our brethren from Saudi Arabia, I want to hear from you, Sister Blessing. I haven't heard your voices for so long, so you are welcome back. I want to hear your voice today. Sister Peace, I know time has gone, but I want to hear your voice. Yes, go ahead.
I learned that if we do not forgive others, God's not going to forgive us, and in that way, we will not enter heaven.
Hi.
So we should forgive people that offend us.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Children, did we hear that? If we do not forgive, God is not going to forgive us. And if God did not forgive us, we will not be able to go to heaven. None of us will go to hell in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Last thing, Sister Peace. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Sapis.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The word forgiveness means to wipe the stain clean in your garment.
Again?
The word forgiveness means to wipe the stain clean from your garment.
To wipe the stain clean from your garment. I pray that Jesus will give each and every one of us that white garment, that we have no spot, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I'm so glad that we all understood the teaching of our sister, and I will pray that God will give her more grace, more wisdom to teach us in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
I can see hands from Ireland, but because of time, we are going to keep it till next week. So all the brethren are raising up hands from Ireland. By God's grace, next week, you are going to tell us everything that you couldn't tell us this evening. We are going to give us time to be able to tell us what you learned. Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Please don't forget the memory verse. Make sure you go over it. If you don't understand anything, ask mommy, daddy to teach you, to tell you what maybe you didn't understand from it. And by God's grace, we are coming to come and recite it. And like we told us, it's not just to recite it in our head. We want to know what it means, and we want to know how we can apply it to our lives. And God will give us the grace to apply His word day by day. We are going to be different. God is going to make us different in our schools, in our communities, in our homes. And our mommies and our daddies, they are going to be glad that we are the children of the Most High God. And most of all, Jesus is going to be happy with us as we do his will in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Now we want to pray. We want to go before the Lord. We want to ask the Lord to please. The word he has taught us today, we know we cannot do it by our power. We want God to give us the grace to have the word of God in our heart so that we will be able to forgive anyone that have wronged us, anyone that have done us any evil. That God will give us the grace to never have unforgiveness in our heart. We'll be able to forgive and forget in Jesus' name. Let's pray. Most high God, thank you for what you have taught us this evening. We have heard your word. Father, if you don't forgive, you will not forgive us. We want you to forgive us, therefore we have to forgive others. We know we cannot do it by our power. We are asking for your power, for your grace, so that we're able to forgive everyone that have offended us in the name of Jesus Christ. Help us, Father, that the word you have taught us this evening, we'll not just know it in the head, we will have it in our heart. We'll be obedient. Obedient children of the Most High God, and we do what you asked us to do. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I'm praying for us now. I want us to pray. I want us to close our eyes as I go to the Lord in prayer. Holy Father, we thank you. We bless your name for how you have taught us this evening. Thank you for your daughter you have used in teaching us about forgiveness. We are asking and praying that more of your wisdom, more of your grace, you bestow upon her in Jesus' mighty name. We pray for all our teachers, oh God, you will teach us so that we're able to teach your children in the name of Jesus. I'm praying for every one of our children here. Father, is there anyone that have not really had that experience with you? Have not known you, Father, Lord, in heaven? We are asking and praying that as they hear this word, because they don't want to go to hell, they want to be with you in heaven. Father, give them the grace to understand and to surrender their lives unto you. And as they come and open their hearts unto you, come in and dwell with them and make them your own in Jesus' mighty name. Father, Lord, give us the grace to go and forgive everyone that have done evil against us in the mighty name of Jesus. As we believe now, we are not leaving your presence. Let your presence continue with us. As we are starting a new week, tomorrow, Lord, in heaven, I pray that your blessing will be upon every one of your children in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father, for your answers to our prayers. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Amen. Shall we share the grace in fellowship?
The
grace.
And
the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with us. With one accord, let's shout, have mercy on us, O Lord. Victory in the name of Jesus Christ. With our hands raised up to heaven, let's shout glory to Jesus Christ. Amen. Can I remind every one of us, please, too? Sadukwe, please help me. Also, if you have any question in anything we have been teaching, please write it down. By the grace of God, next week, we are also going to give a little time for question and answer. Is that okay? If there's anything you don't understand, write it down when we come. will give us opportunity to be able to ask any question, and God will give us the grace to answer it rightly through his word, in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
God bless every one of us. We see us in the church tomorrow, and we see again on Saturday as well, in Jesus' name. Bye-bye, everyone. Bye. Bye.
Yeah.